thought that maybe the first Christmas tree originated with Martin Luther, and he was walking through the woods and the stars were gleaming through the branches of the tree, and he got the idea to bring the tree inside in the at Christmas time, and they would put candles on the tree to replicate the stars sparkling through the tree outdoors. And then eventually the tree became popular to use in the homes, and in the 1800s many ornaments were made and manufactured in cottage industries in the European countries. The first artificial Christmas trees were made in the late 1800s, and they were made from fowl feathers, goose feathers, chicken feathers, ostrich feathers, usually whatever fowl that they ate, they would recycle the feathers. And so someone, but we really don't know who, had the idea that they could make Christmas trees from those feathers. When you wrap the feather around the wire, the feather opens and it looks like a pine branch or a pine tree. And so they started to reproduce or make feather trees then in the late 1800s, and they were popular all the way up until World War II. I first learned of the feather trees because I started to collect antique Christmas ornaments, and then I discovered what a feather tree was and realized then that we had had one in my family, but I didn't know that they were made from feathers. So then I tried to find a feather tree, so I did go to some flea markets and I did locate a couple of feather trees, and they were hard to find because nobody really bought them, so antique dealers didn't even try to sell them because nobody wanted them. And so I learned how to make the trees then by going to a workshop in Pennsylvania that was put on by Crispin Treadway from New York about 35 years ago, and he taught us how to make the feather trees, and I've been making them ever since. What you have to do is decide how tall do you want your tree, and then you have to scale your length of your limbs proportionately with the height, and then you would cut wires using 16 gauge wire. And then that would be used for the branch, and the wire is covered with floral tape, and the end of the wire you use a berry, which then camouflages or covers the end of the wire so you can't see it. The feathers are then wrapped around that wire. After you get all of your branches finished, then you assemble the tree starting at the top, working your way down. So you'd begin with the shortest limbs and work down to the longest. Trees are made as short as 6 inches and as tall as 12 feet. Most of my patterns for the trees I actually have taken those from antique trees, because I also collect the antique feather trees as well. So I take my measurements off of the old trees and then replicate those trees. So we have Halloween trees, we have Easter trees, patriotic trees. So there's usually one for about every 3 months. So many people will buy several trees, and then they have one for each of the holiday seasons. It is a hobby that you can do while you're watching TV in the evening. I can do it in the automobile as long as my wife is willing to drive the car. So it's a nice hobby to have because you can do it in your spare time. The demand is there, but there are only about 3 feather tree makers in all of the United States. And I make and sell approximately 200 trees a year, and I make them anywhere from a 6-inch tree up to about an 8-foot tree. My trees have become popular because I have been picked up by some of the national magazines such as Martha Stewart Living and Victorian Homes and Early American Life, so I've been featured in those publications. I think one of the reasons I enjoy it is because people seem to be very happy with their trees. I've only had one person who purchased a tree for a friend because her friend wanted a feather tree for her birthday. She ordered the tree and I shipped it to her. She called me and said it was the ugliest thing she'd ever seen. Are you sure that my friend is going to want this tree? I said, well, I'll tell you what, you give it to her and if she doesn't like it, you can return it. And it never came back.